Good evening, Lucas. Just got word that the stream is up. And I'll shoot you a thumbs up here, which you'll get before you actually hear this. So. All right, hang tight. We'll talk you down into it once we get into the national anthem.
Thank you.
tied in around 6 minutes. Check, 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 check. You play around with the EQ here a little bit. See if that helps. Yeah, I think so. Brighten it up a little bit. About 3 minutes out. Check, 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 check. Thank you. Warm-up clock winding down. Stand by, anthem about to start.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Jerry Walsh Gymnasium in Maxey Hall for tonight's men's basketball contest featuring the Saints of St. Lawrence and your Potsdam Bears. At this time, we please ask to please...
I will give you a 30-second countdown. Seconds mark. Billboard in 20. And good evening, everyone. Welcome to Potsdam Bears men's basketball. It's the home opener for the Bears, who come in here with a record of 0-1. They opened up on the road this past Tuesday evening at Skidmore. Bears held a 14-point lead in that game at halftime, but Skidmore started raining threes and driving the inside as well with a couple of trees in their lineup. And the Bears came up 3 points short in that one. Meanwhile, their opponent tonight, the St. Lawrence Saints, bring a 3-0 record into this contest. The Saints have defeated Alfred State and Alfred University at the Alfred Invite. The second game over Alfred U in overtime, and they defeated Plattsburgh this past Tuesday night by the score of 85-70. So they are certainly off to a good start and a force to be reckoned with tonight. The Saints will be starting Trey Soroka, Miles Davis, Luke Hicks, Trent Adamson, and Will Engelhart. The last two mentioned players are both 6'7", starting in the lineup. A 6'10 first-year player, Andrew Cowan, is on the bench, at least for the start here tonight. For the Potsdam Bears, first time on home court in ages. As we all know, and the Bears will be going with returning player Tyrese Baptiste, who led his team with 24 points in the loss at Skidmore earlier this week. Mishon Johnson, the freshman from OFA, getting a starting nod at guard. He'll be joined by the returning senior, Brandon Seeger Jr., Brandon at 6'6 out of Jamaica, Queens. Parker Kelly is a 6'7 freshman from Plattsburgh who's looked pretty good early on. And the sophomore transfer in to the Bears lineup this year is Colton Hustis. He hails from Ticonderoga, played a year at a university, a Division II school, I believe in West Virginia. So the Bears with some depth that is being built. A few returning players, including the aforementioned Tyrese Baptiste, Brian Pott, Austin Dropkin, Isaac Oduro Jr., also Dante Viskovich. The Bears have added some muscle this year as well, with not only Kelly at 6'7", but the 6'8 sophomore transfer in from Massachusetts College of Liberal Arts from Lake George, Chris Becker, 6'8", 300 sophomore. And we will expect him to get some playing time here tonight as well. While our focus is on this game tonight, of course, here at Maxey Hall in the Jerry Walsh Gymnasium, we'll also be keeping tabs at a couple of Potsdam teams that are on the road. One road game that was ended up being postponed tonight was Canton at SUNY, or at Potsdam at SUNY Canton. Canton dealing with some COVID issues right now. So all their weekend contests have been wiped off the schedule, or at least pushed into the future. Also, men's hockey on the road at Fredonia and women's hockey at Cortland. But let's get to it here with the Potsdam Bears and the St. Lawrence Saints. We are underway with an opening tap won by the Saints. And they will operate off the left side with Will Englehart coming to the top of the key, picking up his dribble. Hands it off on the right side on a short pass for Adamson. Adamson driving, kicks it back. Englehart to the corner. Baseline drive, kick to the right wing corner. Here's a drive to the basket, sneaking through and sneaking it in there will be Trey Soroka, the 5'11 first-year player from Toledo, Ohio. Saints 2, Bears with their first possession right here with Kelly over for Johnson. Active 3-2 zone, it looks like, here being employed by the Bears. By the Saints. Nice backdoor cut, and the basketball falls off the rim. Long rebound out for Miles Davis. Davis ahead for Soroka. Soroka splits the D, finds his dribble back, kick out to the arc. Elbow jumper is good, and that's for three from Will Englehart, and a quick 5-0 early lead here for the St. Lawrence Saints. They'll keep an active zone, looking like still looking like a 3-2 and a tip pass. Back over to the Saints, looking to expand on their lead. Tipped away by Johnson and saved. Out for Tyrese Baptiste. Baptiste, one-on-one, up, and a charge is called on Baptiste. Kind of saw that one coming. Tyrese tried to duck underneath the defender, who was pretty well set. I think that was Adamson, the 6'7 junior from Ilion. He will be putting it in play here for the St. Lawrence Saints. A minute and 9 into the contest, 5-0. Saints with the lead and the ball. Here's Soroka, top of the key, on the dribble. Short bounce pass left for Adamson. Adamson inside the arc, sets the screen. Houston steps out on that and forces a reset with under 10 to shoot. Inside, up is the short jumper, and off the back iron it goes. Rebound by Brandon Seeger Jr. Seeger, a highly touted player here for Potsdam, who got only 4 games in the last season that the Bears played before going out on injury. His Baptiste ball stripped away, out of bounds, off of his knee, and it's turned back over to the Bears, or actually reset that, or are we getting a foul called? I guess we're getting a Potsdam foul called, I think. No, it's a foul against the Saints. So how is it Saints possession? I guess would be my question. Yeah, well, it isn't. So Meshon Johnson will put it in play here for the Bears. Still looking to get on the board here in their first game at home in forever. Inbound to Seeger Jr. Misses the easy lay-in, but there to clean up the putback on the weak side was Tyrese Baptiste. In behind the defense, block shot, but a foul will be called inside here on Kelly. Nobody got down to the corner, and that's going to put Miles Davis at the line shooting a pair. Chris Downs in his 25th season at the helm of the St. Lawrence men's team, assisted by Marcus Charlton, his first season at that, and some guest assistant coaches, as Miles Davis is his first, Mark Bickelhop, and also the legendary Tom Miller. Second one will bounce through as well, 7-2 Saints. Here come the Bears, looking at a 2-3 zone now. with Kelly. Right side holds. Now puts it on the floor. Bounce pass over to Mishon Johnson, who had come get it. To the left corner for Houston. No good. Offside rebound. Put back up and in by Tyrese Baptiste. Saint 7 in the Bears 4. Almost picked away here by Johnson, who's a staunch defender. Blocks it out of bounds. Keep it with the Saints. Mishon Johnson playing some one-on-one defense. Mishon Johnson, who took his OFA high school team into state tournament play at least a couple of times. Bounce pass stolen away by Seeger. Seeger one-on-one. Seeger ducks underneath. Off glass, no good. A little too strong. He got a little bit too deep before he released that. The rebound to Adamson. Saints on the run. In the paint. Hanger up and good. Score that for Luke Hicks. Saints 9, Bears 4. Baptiste. Drops it down low for Mishon. Kicks to the left wing corner for Houston. Skip across now for Tyrese Baptiste. As Houston goes down the floor on contact. Missed shot. Rebound for Adamson. Check that for Miles Davis. This is Luke Hicks with the ball for St. Lawrence. Back for Hicks. Steps outside the arc. Puts up the three and hits it. St. Lawrence 12. Potsdam 4. Guarding the three, or lack of proficiency in doing that, is what cost the Bears the game pretty much. And a rebounding foul underneath against Potsdam. Over the back, I guess. Against Mishon Johnson, and Coach Jim Bechtel wants a timeout. With St. Lawrence getting the ball back just about 4 minutes in here, he's called a 60-second timeout. Jim Bechtel, sixth year out of Penn State via SUNY Canton for a few years. He's a 2000 graduate of Penn State. Being assisted this year by Danny Del Solari, a 2020 graduate. No 1900s graduates anymore. Danny Del Solari on the bench, also helping out is Justin Todd, new to the program this year officially, who has quite a background in coaching at nearby St. Regis Falls, and the 2011 SUNY Potsdam grad, Eddie Cross, rounding out the assistant coaching ranks here for the Bears tonight. Women's basketball team in back of the Potsdam bench, as mentioned earlier. They were to be playing at SUNY Canton tonight and taking their 3-1 record in there. The Lady Bears with a pretty convincing victory over at Clarkson earlier this week. And after losing their home and season opener against St. Lawrence, a week and a half ago, thereabouts? Yep, about a week and a half ago. Bears have reeled off three straight, including a pair at the Cardinal Classic over in Plattsburgh. So St. Lawrence will have the ball and a 12-4 lead, 16:08 to play in this first half of play. We see that Fredonia has taken a 1-0 lead on the hard luck Potsdam men's hockey team that scored only two goals in its first four games, being shut out on the road this past weekend. Looking to recover and get things turning in the right direction. Back underway here at the Jerry Walsh Gymnasium with Adamson. Holding. Turns. Shoots. And hits. Well, he didn't have an outlet, so he just decided to square up and drop in the 17-footer. It's good for a 10-point Saints lead. 14-4. Seeger down to Baptiste. Puts it on the floor. Tyrese double team. Drops it off to the cutting Mishon Johnson. Hooping the foul. Mishon Johnson, when he played a number of games in high school on this floor, you could certainly see the potential in his game for playing at the next level, and he's starting to show that already here in his first year. Misses on the bonus try, ball tapped around, and securing it will be Luke Hicks. Hicks quickly ahead for Soroka. Soroka around the screen, now puts it, drives hard to the basket, turns, kicks it back out. Adamson, step back, long two, dies off the back rim. Easy rebound for Brandon Seeger Jr. Saints get back on D. Jr. pitches it off now for Baptiste. One dribble over now for Hustis. Back to Hustis now. Tyrese Baptiste drop underneath. Good patient drive to the basket, but a blown lay-in for Brandon Seeger Jr. He wants that one back. So the Saints driving, and they'll pick up a foul on Hustis. That will be Potsdam's third foul. Now they're fourth. Hustis will pick up his third, or his first, rather. We'll get the numbers right here. Still early season for the broadcast crew as well. Here come the Saints with a pitch toward the right wing corner. Drive to the basket. Blocked once. He gets it back. Backing his way in. Hook shot up off the glass. No good. Tyrese Baptiste with a good strong rebound. Off the missed shot inside by Hicks. Here come the Bears trailing 14-6. Ishan Johnson pushes it over to Brandon Seeger Jr. Kickball on the bounce pass attempt. Saints look to be pretty athletic here. And Coach Downs is going to bring three new players in. Let's see, 15, 23, and 24. That would mean Liam McDonald, Aiden McCauley, and the 6'10 first-year player, Andrew Cowan. Bears out of the corner, throw it away in the paint. Back over to St. Lawrence with an 8-point advantage, 14-15 to play first half. Sneak pass out to the right side for Cowan. Cowan holds, now finds the open man for three. Looks good, a little bit short, and that ball gets caught up. Hung up in the guy wire, which is no easy feat, but it's there. So it'll be back over to the Bears. As soon as we get that ball out of there, it's right underneath the shot clock. And they got it out of there fine. So back over to Potsdam. The Bears still looking for this starting five to gel. And I suspect they will. A lot of talent on the floor out here right now for Potsdam. But they're trailing by eight with the ball. Hustis off the screen. Pitches over to Kelly. Kelly holds. Now we'll put it on the floor. Swings it back over to Colton Hustis. Down toward the corner baseline. Seeger for Hustis. Shot clock now at seven. Hustis is going to drive the basket. Puts it up and in. Nice, sweet move right there. Laying off of the contact. And Colton Hustis has a bucket. It is 14-8, St. Lawrence. Saints working now with Aiden McCauley to the right side for Big Trent. And make that Andrew Cowan. Now they get it over for McCauley. McCauley drives baseline, kicks it out high. Lost dribble, hustle for the loose ball. Hustis can't quite get to it. Valiant effort, turnaround mid-range, no good. Off the left side of the rim and taken away by Potsdam's Parker Kelly. Ishan Johnson now down into the left corner. Kick back now for Seeger Jr. Long three misses off the back rim. Easy rebound underneath for the Saints. Stop and pop for three the other way. That's good for Will Engelhart. And the Saints open up a 9-point lead once again at 17-8. Actually, their first 9-point lead, I think. They've been up by as many as 10. Colton Hustis to Brandon Seeger Jr. Seeger on the dribble just beyond the top of the key, extended. Back out to Seeger, around the screen. Goes in there with a wide drive toward the basket, and well-timed swat away there by the 6'10 first-year player, Andrew Cowan from Barnett, Vermont. Played at St. Jay Academy. So it'll stay with the Bears. Down 17-8. Johnson in for Kelly. Cross court Hustis. In for Tyrese Baptiste. Misses the lay-in. Second try from Johnson. That's blocked and saved underneath by the Saints. So the Bears struggling a little bit against this St. Lawrence bigger lineup. Good protection of the ball right there on the drive, but a missed shot for Luke Hicks. Bears back down court with a stop and pop for Houston. That's short. And Hicks will take probably the easiest rebound he'll get all night. St. Lawrence 17, Potsdam 8. Saints with Cowan. Brings it out to the arc. Sets the screen now here for Hick. Now for Cowan. Back outside. Three, that's going to be wide left. And a good box out by Colton Eustace. Keyshawn Johnson caught a finger in the eye, but he's going to hustle back down court and join the rush. And that's a jump ball right there against Kelly, or on with Kelly, as getting a hand on it as Kelly was trying to get away was Luke Hicks. So Hicks playing some pretty good two-way ball right now himself for St. Lawrence. Bears ball side out, 20 on the shot. Eustace sneaks a nice pass through. Outside it goes, up and short. Rebound underneath, and there to pick it up and clean it up and score again is Tyrese Baptiste. Following the missed three from Potsdam's Jeff Williamson, the freshman from Brooklyn who just came in the lineup. And here comes a Potsdam foul, and this is going to go against the big man, Tyrese Baptiste. And I think that may be two on Tyrese, and that is going to bring him to the bench as we near the midpoint of this first half. Saints 17 and Potsdam 10, and my first look of the year at Chris Becker, the 6'8 sophomore from Lake George, who I think probably played a high school playoff game en route to a state championship on this floor. Not the state championship game, but a regional final. I'm pretty sure he played on this team along with RG3. He's making a name for himself at Syracuse University. Screenshot long, offensive rebound. A hustle rebound there for Andy Downs, son of the coach. Played his high school ball at UC Williams High School in Canton. Here's a ball thrown away. Kelly, great pass ahead for Houston. Up and lay it in for two. Colton wanted to jam it there, but ball kind of got caught up in his hands and he made the sure two. Saints Lee cut the five, and Houston is going to get called on the hack here. Saints not afraid to drive the basket here tonight, at least over the first quarter of this game. Houston's trying to make a bid for a travel call instead of the foul that was called against him. At the line is Aiden McCauley. McCauley, first shot no good, comes up short. Again, keeping tabs on both of the Potsdam hockey teams. Men in action at Fredonia, trailing 1-0. Potsdam women are at Cortland. We'll get an update on that game in a little bit. We'll try to get some scores from other SUNYAC teams in action. Still all non-league affairs until next weekend, when the Bears open SUNYAC play here at home. All the details forthcoming as the Bears trail 17-12. Both free throws miss. Here's Viskovich on the floor. And a deep three there. That's going to come off no good for Potsdam's number 20, Jeff Williamson. Williamson first off the bench here tonight for Potsdam. Here's Hicks. Decides against the three. Puts it on the floor. It's picked off by the Bears with good presence in the lane. Kelly, the freshman, holds, looking for Viskovich, who's not really open enough. He'll get it now. Kick back out for Eshawn Johnson. Kelly, straight on three. Looks good, is good. Parker Kelly, the freshman from Plattsburgh, with the three ball. And the Bears close within that many points at 18-15. St. Lawrence up by as many as 10 in the early going of this game. They'll try to respond with a three of their own. That's going to be short. Eshawn Johnson will track down the ball as it drops off the side of the rim. And Eshawn is fouled as he released his pass. So the Bears can tie the game with a three. 9:02 on the clock here in the first half. St. Lawrence 18, Potsdam 15. Kelly is out and in for Potsdam. Here's Brian Pod, 6-foot sophomore from Oceanside, New York. Potsdam ball underneath. Johnson will look to put it in. Does so to Pod in the left corner. Sends it up high now. Here is Viskovich. Long three off the top of his hand. Long rebound off to Missy. Right back to him. Viskovich, thinking again of the three, will go to Williamson and now Mishon Johnson. And here's Viskovich putting up no good. Weak side rebound and an offensive putback here for Chris Becker. And the Bears are within a point. Hicks off a strong pick set by Adamson. Hicks still with the ball. Becker tried to reach around and deny the pass, and now we're going to get a touch foul here, and that's all it is, folks. That will go on Becker. Didn't look like much, but enough to be called. Aaron Kinsey, Tyree Allen, Dean Crouch, the officials here tonight. I don't know that we've ever seen any one of these guys. Perhaps, I don't want to say. I can't really say. They just don't look like familiar officials here in Suniac, or non-league play here is what we're still in, of course. Potsdam ball down by one. Adamson. Make that Williamson. Williamson for Potsdam. Out for Mishon Johnson. Williamson over to Pod. Drops it to the baseline. Bears passing the ball well. Here's Mishon cruising baseline. Good strong pass. Williamson will drive the lane. Hang it up there. And good. And the Bears have their first lead on the two-point bucket by Jeff Williamson. Potsdam 19 and St. Lawrence 18. The Bears have come from 10 down to take a one-point lead. 7:44 to play in the first half. Lots of screening going on here by the Saints, especially up around the arc. Now to the free throw line. They will go one on one, and getting behind and scoring will be Trent Adamson on a nice move to sneak around Becker. The lead swings back to St. Lawrence at 20-19. Viskovich to Mishon Johnson. Back to Dante. Played his high school ball up in Messina. Viskovich, long three, short. Again, coming kind of flat off his shooting hand right now. Back come the Saints with a one-point lead. Double teamed, and it's thrown away. Ahead of the pack, Mishon, up, score. Bears back on top at 21-20. 6:45 to play in a fast-moving first half. St. Lawrence ball down a point. And here comes a missed shot inside, this time from Trent Adamson. Bears with Pod for three, short off the front rim. Had a good look right there. Came up a little bit short, and Saints will call timeout as Andy Downs crosses midcourt. And calls the TO, 6:24 on the first half clock. Potsdam 21, St. Lawrence 20. Men's college hockey tonight, the 0-4 Potsdam Bears against the 3-2 Fredonia Blue Devils. And the Blue Devils, with 2:15 to play in the first period, have a 2-0 lead. Potsdam women's hockey doesn't look like they've started. Portland off to a strong start in women's play. Yeah, I guess they haven't started yet. 4-1 overall is Portland against the 1-2-1 Potsdam Bears. This is an NEWHL league contest here tonight for the Bears. And we'll see if anything else is cooking around the Yak or involving Suniac teams. Geneseo at home against Rutgers Camden, owning them right now. 2 minutes before halftime, Geneseo 47, Rutgers Camden 15. No other scores being reported from games that include Keystone at Oneonta, Ohio Northern at Buff State, Vassar at New Paltz, and Skidmore playing up in Plattsburgh tonight. That's a 7:30 start, as is the Buff State game for that matter. The New Paltz contest scheduled for 8 o'clock, perhaps part of a weekend invite of some sort, maybe. Don't get a lot of 8 o'clock starts for single games anymore. Saints off of the timeout, trailing by a point. Andy Downs. Take that Trey Soroka now out at the point. Hands it off now for Trent Adamson. Adamson sets the screen. The three is up. The three is good. For 33, Will Engelhart. St. Lawrence 23, Potsdam 21. Saints 3-0 entering tonight's action. Bears dropping a heartbreaker in their season opener on the road at Skidmore Tuesday evening. With the ball now for Viskovic. Kick to the right wing corner. That three ball up, no good. Ball kept alive out of bounds. Gave it back to St. Lawrence. So the Bears are getting some open looks, and right now the three balls are just not falling with any kind of regularity. Let's see if we can get some running team stats here. Yeah, Bears are 1 of 10. Yeah, only 1 of 10 from beyond the arc. So there's your story right there. 23-21, Saints with the lead and the ball. Down low, Adamson. Adamson backing in against Kelly. Hooks it up there. Scored and a foul. I don't know if it's going to be Kelly on a reach or maybe one of the other players nearby. Coach Bechtel questioning the wisdom of that call. And the bonus bucket is up and in for Trent Adamson, the 6'7 junior from Ilion. Certainly leading his team inside tonight. Saints are back up by 5 at 26-21. Brandon Seeger Jr. back in, throws the ball away as Viskovic was caught going the wrong way. Downs drops it off. And a foul right there. That was actually, again, Trey Soroka. And another Potsdam foul. That is going to be their 8th. Right? Or 6th. I think it's probably their 8th. So at the line is Engelhart. He scores on his first attempt. Brian Pott out. Austin Dropkin, another 6-foot sophomore, checking in for the Bears. Austin coming in here from New Hartford. As Engelhart gets the ball back, looking to cash in charity times 2. It's up and it's good. So the Saints on a bit of a run right here. By my count, 8-0 to take a 28-21 lead. And take the lead away from the Bears. Kelly swings it over. Williamson inside. Baptiste and a travel call. I guess on Tyrese, I guess. Tough to pick it up from where I was with a crowd around him as he caught that ball in the paint and turned toward the basket. Saints up 7. Soroka, right side it goes, Engelhart. Engelhart, good ball handler back to Soroka. Top of the key extended, Dropkin watches him. And now Soroka on the floor. Blows through the basket, no good, but an offensive rebound for Trent Adamson. And the Saints reset with the three that rims off, no good. Tyrese Baptiste will get the rebound this time for Potsdam, up ahead for Dropkin. Dropkin kicks it out for Williamson. Williamson driving in. Pitch back outside. Dropkin, three, in and out. Got robbed on that one. It looked good on the way up. It just would not drop through. Three ball not clicking yet for the Potsdam Bears. Finding themselves down by 7 points. Just under 4 minutes to play in the opening half. Englehart, quick move inside, and a travel call. Yep. Fair call right there. Coach Downs not showing any signs of dismay over that call. So again, Potsdam down just 7 points here. 3:45 to play in the first half. Dropkin, as Soroka jumps out on him, Dropkin will hand it off to Brandon Seeger Jr. 17-footer up, no good. Tipped around, and there's the putback for Viskovic, his first points. That brings Potsdam within 5 points at 28-23. Soroka, top of the key against Dropkin. Entry pass is for Adamson. Adamson drops it underneath, maybe getting away with a travel right there, but scoring anyway was Will Englehart. Saints 30, Bears 23. Saints hustling back on defense, and this 3-2 zone, or 2-3 zone now that they're employing, has been giving the Bears fits. Another missed shot in tight for Potsdam. Rebound to Soroka. He'll bring it up against Dropkin. And he bowls over Viskovic. Charge? I think it should be. No, it's going to be a blocking foul on Viskovic. Looked to me like he was pretty well set. But the call will go against Dante. So to the line will go Trey Soroka. That's team foul number 10 on the Bears. Just three here against St. Lawrence in this first half. And Coach Bechtel is going to call a 30-second timeout before Soroka takes his first free throw attempt. First intermission in Fredonia. The Bears trailing the Blue Devils by the score of 2-0. See, the Bears are finding some shots on goal here. Yeah, actually, the Bears have outshot Fredonia in the first period, 18-16. But find themselves trailing 2-0. And the goal-scoring drought continues early in the campaign here for the Potsdam Bears. We'll be seeing them before Christmas. And we'll be seeing a lot of the basketball teams next weekend as they open Suniac play. But in between now and next weekend comes a Sunday afternoon contest. This Sunday, like 2 days away, 2 o'clock against the Clarkson University Golden Knights. So following the Potsdam 30-second timeout, St. Lawrence's Trey Soroka, first-year guard out of Toledo, Ohio, goes to the free-throw line and delivers on his first. Coach Downs certainly doing a fine job of recruiting some skilled and speedy players into his lineup. And Soroka being one of them, and he hits on both free throws, and the lead is back up to 9. Saints 32, Bears 23. Dropkin over for Viskovic, back for Dropkin. Viskovic on the arc, puts up the 3. Falls off short, off the near side of the rim. Saints rebound for Aiden McCauley. McCauley still on the dribble here against Austin Dropkin. Drops it off for Adamson. Adamson against Tyrese Baptiste. Adams pushing him off. Shot misses. Tyrese will play the carom. And the Bears push it up ahead for Hustis. Hustis loosely the handle, but the ball is back out and kept alive here by Brandon Seeger. Here's Hustis, open for 3. Count it, and a foul! Hustis starting to find his stride right now. That's a good thing, because the Bears, prior to that, made 3. We're just 1 of 11. Actually, 1 of 12. Now 2 of 13. So that's a start. Saints have hit 4 of their 9 attempts from the outside. So a chance at a 4-point play here. A most welcome opportunity here for the Potsdam Bears. Eustace on the bonus try. It is good. And off the bench once again comes Jeff Williamson in for Austin Dropkin, who had a nice shift out there for Potsdam. Saints with a 5-point lead, a minute 45 to play in the first half. 32-27, wide open left corner, missing the three was Miles Davis. Saints get the weak side long rebound. Pick is set. With the ball is McCauley. McCauley in for Adamson. Adamson holds. Back out McCauley. McCauley, one dribble and out for Soroka. Hangs one up there. And boy, did he really sell that soft contact. Meshon Johnson cannot believe it. If there were such a thing as an embellishment penalty in basketball, that I think would be grounds for one. So Soroka back to the line for two, hitting his first. Saints in the double bonus. And the Bears still far away from 1-1. Soroka misses the second. So the lead will get set at 6, 33-27. Bears at 45. Now Baptiste throws it away. Right into the hands of Soroka. Soroka called on a travel. As he got hooked up with Brandon Seager. Make that Williamson playing some defense underneath for Potsdam. And now in for the Bears comes Reginald Smith Jr., new player to the Bears. Played some D1 ball. I believe I'm pretty sure they're Division I, Bethesda University in California. But he's from Chicago. So let's see what Reginald Smith Jr. has to offer as he camps out in the left corner, gets the ball, swings it quickly back out for Meshon Johnson. Around the horn. Viskovich, right corner three, off glass, no good. Rebounded by Andy Downs. Leads the pack back the other way for St. Lawrence. Baseline goes the pass. Adamson pump fake and scores it in a crowd. Boy, he is tough to stop inside. Half a minute to go. Saints by eight. Late in the first half here at the Jerry Walsh Gymnasium. Saints looking every bit like a 3-0 team right now. Bears will hold for the final shot. Or at least that's the intention here with now 10 seconds to go in the half. Meshon Johnson off to Viskovich. Viskovich to the left corner. Bears are going to get a shot away. It's going to be Seager. He's short. And St. Lawrence will enjoy an 8-point lead here at halftime on the road at SUNY Potsdam. A very quick and talented St. Lawrence University squad with an 8-point advantage here at halftime. St. Lawrence 35 and Potsdam 27. Take a look at some team numbers before we get the individual recap. From the field, St. Lawrence 11 of 26 overall, good for 42.3%. 4 of 10, I'll let you do the math, from beyond the arc, and 9 of 12 at the free throw line. I'll let you figure out that percentage too. For the Potsdam Bears, just 12 of 35 from the field. Good for a 34.3% clip. And only 2 of 14 from beyond the arc. 1 of 2, limited opportunity at the free throw line. Turnovers even at 7 aside. But the Saints have 5 more points off of turnovers than do the Bears, 9-4 in that department. And St. Lawrence in total rebounds with a slight edge of 21-19. Defensively is where the Saints get their advantage, 16-11 on D boards over the Bears. And Potsdam with an edge of 8-5 in offensive rebounds, thanks largely to the work of Tyrese Baptiste. Couple of blocks for the Bears, 1 for the Saints. 5 Potsdam steals, 4 from St. Lawrence.
Potsdam committing 11 fouls in that first half. Saints whistle for only four. And Potsdam getting 6 points from their bench. And just one for the Saints. Second chance points. Again, with a decided edge in offensive rebounds, the Bears on second chances, outscoring St. Lawrence 10-1. Points in the paint. St. Lawrence with a dozen, which seems a little odd, to Potsdam's 20. Fast break points, St. Lawrence 9, and Potsdam with 4 of those. Let's check in on SUNY Cortland and see if we can get an update. Well, apparently, if this score hole is correct, there is no score in Potsdam women's hockey action tonight at Cortland, 0-0. And they are, is that at the end of the second period? I don't think so. I think that's got to be first intermission. That was indeed a 7 o'clock start. So no score for the women on the road at Cortland, and they're in the first intermission at Fredonia with the home team there, leading the Potsdam men's hockey team by the score of 2-0. Anything else happening to report for you from SUNYAC teams? I don't think so. We'll do a refresh here. Yeah, and we can tell you that Geneseo, as they get ready to start the second half at home against Rutgers Camden, with a commanding 52-21 lead. No scoring from Keystone at Oneonta. That was also a 7 o'clock start. The other games, including Plattsburgh at home, Buff State at home, New Paltz at home, all starting later. Well, 7:30 starts for the two of them, and Vassar at New Paltz scheduled for an 8 o'clock tip. And don't forget, we are back here on Sunday afternoon. 2 o'clock is tip time for a game you'll hear live here on the SUNY Potsdam Bearcast, and of course live on Mix 96.1. Glad to have you along here at Courtside. I'm Warren Potter. So glad you are able to join us here on this busy Friday night, including that includes SUNY Potsdam teams. Swimming going on as well. Sports information guru Dan Bronson telling me. And here come our first half stats. Thank you. So we can look at some individual numbers before we take a little bit of a break. For the Saints, they are led in scoring by the game-high scoring so far of Will Engelhardt. He has 13 points to lead all. A couple of rebounds to go along as well. Next up is Trent Adamson, 9 points here at the half and 4 rebounds. And a couple of 5-point offerings from Trey Soroka and Luke Hicks. A few other points scattered about the rest of the lineup. For the Potsdam Bears, balanced attack so far. Just not a whole lot of production from any one player. Leading the way for Potsdam is Colton Hustis with 8 here at the break. Tyrese Baptiste with 6. 4 points from Mishan Johnson, 3 from Parker Kelly, 2 apiece for Williamson, Becker, and Viskovich. And we gave you the recap on all the team numbers. Biggest lead in the first half for the Saints came early on within the first 4-plus minutes when they were up by as many as 10. The Bears have had 1-point leads a couple of times. And scoring runs. I like this stat. It helps to tell the story of the game. This statistic being made available to us this season, it would appear. Best scoring run, the Saints with 8 in a row, and the Bears ended up with 7 in a row. That was after they, I'm pretty sure after they got down by 10 points or so. So that's what we have for you here so far. And at the break, it is St. Lawrence 35 and the Potsdam Bears 27. We're going to take a break. Step aside for a few moments. Catch our collective breath. And when we come back, it'll be time for the start of the second half. It's the home opener for the Potsdam Bears men's basketball team. first of two games this weekend here on their home court. Bears will look to rebound literally and figuratively in the second half as they will hit the court trailing by 8 points. Again, your score here at the half is St. Lawrence 35 and Potsdam 27. You're listening to Potsdam Bears basketball live on the SUNY Potsdam Bearcast and Mix 96.1. We're back in a few minutes. All right, Mix 96, I'll talk to you in around about 6 minutes or so. Thanks.
Yeah.
All right, Knicks 96-1. Let's get ready to bring this baby down to get my stopwatch up. And let's cue you at 30 seconds until return billboard. 30 seconds. In 10. Sorry, in 15. Yes, 15 seconds to billboard. Now in 10. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Roll billboard, please, and thank you. Glad to have you back, everyone, here on Mix 96.1 and the SUNY Potsdam Bearcast, home of Potsdam Bears winter sports. We'll continue again on Sunday afternoon with more men's basketball as the Bears will continue their local matchups against the crosstown rival Clarkson Golden Knights. 2 o'clock tip on Sunday afternoon. Make sure you're tuning in. And in amongst all the football games. Here at halftime, the Bears have had a couple of one-point leads, but find themselves down 35-27 to the visiting St. Lawrence Saints, who entered the game tonight with a record of 3-0. Most recently, a 15-point win against SUNY Plattsburgh. Bears, meanwhile, this past Tuesday night, opened up their season on the road at Skidmore. Had a 14-point lead at halftime, but end up falling by 3, giving up 49 points to the Thoroughbreds in the second half, largely on the 3-ball. And they've held St. Lawrence fairly well in check here tonight in that category. Saints are 4 of 10, but the other contributing factor in that category is the fact that the Bears have just 2 3-pointers on 14 attempts. And that has certainly brought their overall field goal percentage down a lot lower than they want it to be. You want to be, mid-40s generally? Right now they're at 34.3% from the floor. So let's see what kind of adjustments head coach Jim Bechtel has made. Saints have been out on the floor for a while now in their warm-ups, or doing their warm-ups. And Saints will have the ball to start off our second half. Here we go. Inbounded to Trey Soroka. And right off the bat, we have a whistle. All tipped out of bounds, apparently. Do-over. Oh, shot clock didn't start, that's why. That's what happened. So they got to reset the shot clock to 26, or, probably should be 25, since we have 5 seconds gone on the game clock. They're working on it. It's opening night for the men. Just the second basketball game overall this season as the Potsdam women hang out behind the men's team in the stands. They were scheduled to play at SUNY Canton tonight, but Canton having some COVID protocol issues and impacts. There we go. So their game will have to be rescheduled, as will a number of other SUNY Canton games scheduled for this weekend. Now Coach Downs is looking perhaps for, I don't know why he would want to take another second off the shot clock. Oh, now we're just going to reset and restart the second half. And so just pretend all that never happened. Because in effect, it really didn't.
Inbounded here, and Soroka. Now second half is underway, and there's another whistle.
4-what?
I have no idea. Both clocks ran. I could not tell you in this case what is going on. Ready to go, boys? Let's do this. Or maybe not. I'll go over to the timers. Oh, perhaps the possession arrow didn't change. There we go. Yeah, so with the Saints inbound, the possession arrow apparently never got switched back over to Potsdam. All right, I think we're going to play some ball now. And we are. We're low kicks, top of the key, right side Soroka. Kick sets the pick. Gets the ball back from Soroka. Kicks dangerously close, I thought, to carrying the ball. Soroka, dribble penetration, pulls back toward the left corner, one-on-one, and that's a charge. A charge taken by Tyrese Baptiste, and that'll be a foul on Trent Adamson. So the first foul of the half comes on St. Lawrence's first possession. And Adamson trying to wish his way out of the corner on the baseline. Tyrese was having none of it. So back to the Bears. They trail by 8 points here. Just underway in the second half for real. 2-3 extended zone. Kelly over from Eshawn Johnson. Back to Kelly. Straight away. Here's Tyrese on the floor. Quick move to the basket. He gets fouled. And should be two shots coming. Nope, it's not going to be. I'm going to call it on the floor. Tyrese tried to show shot. But the Bears will keep it underneath with just 9 to shoot. Is that right? No, it can't be right. Now we've reset the shot clock to 20. Early season jitters here at the Jerry Walsh Gymnasium. And the Bears work down from that 20-second shot clock to Brandon Seeger. Back out for Colton Huestis. Skips it over Mishon. Mishon for Huestis. Huestis. Could it get called on to travel? I thought he released that ball before that extra step was taken, but apparently not. So a rather choppy start to the first half or second half here both ways, and the first minute of the second half is in the books. And score has not changed. St. Lawrence with the ball and a lead of 35-27. With the ball is Trent Adamson. Adamson still holding. Dangerously close to a 5-second call there. Soroka bails him out, tries to get underneath, got too far underneath, steps on the baseline. Well, let's see if the Bears can take advantage of that turnover afforded them. Trailing 35-27. Eshawn Johnson picks up his dribble, needs somebody to go to. Tyrese pops out, gets it back over for Eshawn on the near side. Bounce pass in for Kelly. Kelly against Adamson. Doesn't want to take the shot. We'll hand it off for Tyrese. Sneaks through, and that ball was tied up, I guess. All right. Bears say there was contact that caused it. And we have a Potsdam ball underneath. Yeah, they did have the arrow. Inbounded for Baptiste. Tyrese starts driving, hands it off. Seeger, turnaround, short two, no good. The Bears shooters, by and large, not finding it yet. And missed shot inside from Seeger. 2 minutes gone, second half. Saints still up 35-27. That's where we were at halftime. Screen set, deep three, no good. Long rebound, right back out for the Saints. Mid-range jumper, that won't hit. Third try at it, and they draw a foul. Nobody boxing out Adamson and three cracks at the basket, draws a foul on the third try. Two free throws at the line, looking to push the lead out to 10 once again, which would equal their largest. Not going to happen on this trip, as Adamson rims out the first try. Second try, this one will round off as well. So, a foul but no harm, I guess, in this case. Here's Hustis off the screen, sends it over for Seeger Jr. Seeger looking inside, keeping the ball on the outside for Meshawn Johnson. Swings it out to Kelly, not open for three, goes to the baseline. Swings it back out. Meshawn, seven to shoot. Nice pass down for Tyrese. Near side, lay-in, score that for Tyrese Baptiste. And finally, nearly 3 minutes into the second half, we get our first bucket, 35-29. Bears down now by six. Adamson hands it back. Step back. Long two. Dies off the rim. No good. Hustis the rebound. Bears up ahead. Meshawn in behind the defense. And it rolls off. No good. Coach Bechtel says it rolled off. It missed because there was contact on his shot. 35-29. St. Lawrence with a six-point lead and the ball. Ball knocked away from Adamson. He'll get it back and hand it off for Hustis. Check that for Trey Soroka. Soroka, tough shot over, over a Potsdam defender and a second chance basket for three from Will Engelhardt. Timeout, Potsdam. And Jim Bechtel's looking for an official who will listen to him. Nobody offering their ear yet. Coach Bechtel upset at what he feels are some non-calls that have gone on. But it is a Potsdam timeout as the Bears trail by nine, 38-29. Let's take a moment here to look at other Potsdam Bears teams in action tonight. With just under 7 minutes to go in the second period, the Fredonia Blue Devils continue with their 2-0 lead on the visiting Potsdam Bears in men's hockey. And Cortland in women's play has put up three goals in the second period to take a 3-0 lead on the visiting Lady Bears. And don't imagine we're going to get too many other reports involving Suniac teams in basketball. Yeah, just Geneseo. They're rolling it up on Rutgers Camden, 76-49, with about 8 minutes to play in that one. All right, back to live action here. Potsdam trailing by 9 points, 38-29. Meshawn Johnson crosses midcourt, hands off to Tyrese Baptiste. Tyrese now for Brandon Seeger Jr. Really needs to get uncorked here with the scoring. Tyrese will go inside to him again. Turn to the basket, up and in. Tyrese continues to dominate the interior for Potsdam offensively. 7-point game. Engelhardt for Adamson. Adamson back for Engelhardt off the screen. Back down low. Adamson backing his way in. Loses track of the ball. Poked away by Tyrese Baptiste. Here comes Meshawn. Wanted to break it deep down the left wing side. They'll find it into the corner for Hustis. Big move into the lane. Score the bucket. And a foul. Colton Hustis showing some quickness. A quick first step. He gets into high gear in a hurry. You'll recall that he ended up with a 4-point opportunity. Now a 3-point opportunity right here of the old-fashioned variety. It's up and it's good. So Hustis closes the Bears within 5 points. At make that 4 points now at 38-34. We're still early in the second half, less than 5 minutes gone by. About four and a half now. As Soroka will hand it off to big Andrew Cowan. Cowan now over for Soroka. Around the pick. Soroka in the lane.
Nothing open there. They'll pitch it off to the wing. Back to Soroka from the outside. Hangs one up there. Left it short. Well short. Right for Brandon Seeger Jr. Seeger throws it away for Will Engelhardt. Ball knocked away. Tie ball. And possession arrow will give it to St. Lawrence. And we have Mishon Johnson down on the floor. And he is in some pain. Grabbing now his left knee. So we will get the trainers.
I don't know what's up. Coke in my coat.
So Mishon Johnson in a whole lot of discomfort. Hopefully all it is just a kneecap hit hard to the floor. So they will tend to him just off to our left here at half court. Courtside here tonight from the Jerry Welsh Gymnasium. So the clock stops with 15:06 to play in the second half. The Bears down 8 points at halftime have closed to within four at 38-34. And Mishon is up and walking off under his own power. Yeah, I'm hoping that's all it is. And it would appear that is all it is. Just sometimes it's not that it's like hitting your funny bone, but you know, that same type of immediate sting. And he's just going to walk this one off. Into the game for Potsdam comes Austin Dropkin. And Austin with some real good minutes off the bench in the latter stages of the first half. Pressed into action here, maybe a little earlier than he thought he might. Johnson's continuing to walk it off on the sidelines. Saints ball with a 4-point lead. 15 minutes to play, second half. Soroka, as the Bears extend the defense, going to get Seeger on a little reach. Again, didn't look like much, but apparently enough to call. And that'll be Potsdam's second team foul of the second half. Now what's our issue? I couldn't tell you. Oh, shot clock. All right. Long inbounds, knocked away by Tyrese. Can't quite grab it down sidelines. Back over to St. Lawrence. So Tyrese Baptiste reading that long inbounds toss from the baseline out near midcourt along the wing. Poked it away from the intended receiver, but couldn't quite track it down. Great effort nonetheless by big number zero. Saints with Engelhardt, top of the key, shading left. Drops off Soroka, off the pick and roll. Three ball, no good. Hustis will get the rebound away from his teammate, Brandon Seeger Jr. Here's Dropkin. Dropkin pushes for Seeger. Seeger's going to go in, drop it off. Last moment, up goes Kelly, and he draws the foul. And Kelly's going to shoot a couple at the line. Parker looking for the baseline jam. That was denied, but two free throws coming his way as Coach Bechtel calls the other four players on the floor over to the sidelines. Kelly misses his first free throw attempt as Andy Downs comes back in for St. Lawrence, replacing Miles Davis. Patrick Kelly, the 6'7 freshman out of Plattsburgh. Good on the second try. Nice correction in his form right there, and the Bears are down just three. 38-35. Here's Downs with the ball, top of the key. Downs hands it off for Engelhardt. Holds, waits. Now for Soroka, off the screen. That's shut down. Drives in toward the basket and scores and draws some kind of foul from somebody. Well, Soroka with that elusive quickness. Just a 5'11 guard, but boy, he is quick and he's got a terrific shot. So a chance at a 3-point play for him. Scoreboard has been corrected, I think. No, I don't think it has. There it is. Now it is. A 40-35. Cashes in on the bonus to make it 41-35 now. St. Lawrence with a six-point advantage over the Potsdam Bears here on home opening night. Skip pass, a dangerous one. Houston's will get it, though. Floater short baseline. You see that? That was going to come up short as soon as it left his hand. Here comes Soroka. Stop and go move against Dropkin. Turn around. Swings it outside. Drive through the lane. They throw it away. Bears will have it going down. Down a couple of possessions. It has not been the smoothest of games overall for the Potsdam offense tonight. Again, you know, a lot of new players in the mix here this year on the comeback year from COVID and a lost season. And Downs ties up his former Northern Athletic Conference Central Division rival, Meshawn Johnson. And possession arrow will keep it with the Bears. Meshawn gets the ball quickly over for Kelly. Kelly, nice pass down low on the reverse, Eustace. A no-look pass from Kelly on the money. Houston scores, and the Bears down four. 41-37. 13 to play. As Hicks gives to Englehart. Around the screen, ball poked away. And out of bounds, keep it with the Saints. 14 on the shot clock. Front court inbound for St. Lawrence. Soroka floats it to Hicks. Hicks holds, looking baseline, nothing open. Five to shoot. Here comes Adamson in, and he'll score on the left-handed lay-in just before the shot clock expires. 43-37 St. Lawrence. Jumping out in that active, very active 2-3 zone. Back door for Houston. Now right side. Kelly for three. Good! Patrick Kelly. And it's a three-point ball game. Parker Kelly make that. Back comes Soroka the other way. Pushes off. That's the charge. If the Bears can continue to play good, strong, stand-up defense, set defense, at that point of approaching the basket, let's say about 5 feet out, 5-6 feet out or so, Soroka can be shut down, or he can be neutralized on drives like that. Because he operates with so much quickness, typically he doesn't allow the defense to get set. Here's the ball stripped away from Eustace. I guess off of Colton and out of bounds, I guess. 12:04 on the clock. St. Lawrence 43, Potsdam 40. Meshawn Johnson, after what was a little bit scary injury timeout there for a moment, he's back out on the floor. And thankfully, it's not anything worse than what it was, which was practically nothing. Safe throw away. A pass from McCauley over to the wing for Hicks. And Hicks, who stands at 6'4 already, the senior couldn't get high enough for that one. Bears can tie with a three. Meshawn Johnson, backdoor cut and put down by Parker Kelly. Bears within a point. That should make the highlight reel. Contact inside, an offensive foul on the Saints. And the Bears can regain the lead. As we get a timeout called by St. Lawrence. Yes, we do. A 30-second timeout for them. Coach Downs will discuss that last call. I presume that's what he's talking about. But the Bears draw another charge down low. The defense starting to step up. Can the offense follow? We'll find out following the St. Lawrence timeout with Potsdam trailing 43-32.
Now they just made it 43 all, which is not right. I don't know where that extra point came from, but I do not believe it should be tied at 43. Well, let's check in on some hockey. It's now 3-0 Fredonia, second intermission, hosting the Potsdam men. 3-0 Cortland, second intermission, hosting the Potsdam women. Those two teams will continue league play on the road. The men at Buffalo State tomorrow. And I presume the Potsdam women will be back in action as well. Have to check their schedule for you. I really don't think the scoreboard is right. It's showing a tie ball game at 43. I believe the Bears are down a point, 43-42. As Kelly has it here. Nice pass, strong pass. Hustis, right corner, way long on the three. Weak side rebound, put back for Ty Reese Baptiste. Bears are on top for real, 45-43. Okay, or 44-43. Here comes St. Lawrence. A lot of high screens being set. They'll go to the left wing corner. Here comes Downs. Drops it off. Block shot, but a foul as well. Who are they going to get? They're going to get Baptiste. And for Tyrese, I believe that is three fouls now. 10:40 on the clock. I still don't think that scoreboard is right, as Will Engelhardt bricks one no good. One more coming for Will Engelhardt as Big Andrew Cowan checks back in. So Coach Downs going with his best size underneath. As Baptiste comes out. And Engelhardt's second shot up, no good. Rebound for Brandon Seeger Jr. Right wing corner. Skipped out here. And around the right side they go. Dribble penetration, baseline hanger. Kelly, no good. Rebound for Aiden McCauley. Check that for Engelhardt, number 33. Here's McCauley with the ball. Potsdam 44, St. Lawrence 43. Here's Engelhardt, puts it down for Cowan, and we get a Potsdam foul that looks like a travel, potentially, but maybe it was contact that caused what looked to be kind of a slide step there from Cowan. Team foul number 5 on the Bears. That'll be the first on Jeff Williamson. Downs puts it in toward the corner, brought quickly back out for Engelhardt. To the right side, Hicks, one-on-one. Off the screen, deep three, no good. Easy rebound for Brandon Seeger Jr. Bears up by a point at 44-43. Tip pass into the corner. Williamson will get it for Potsdam. Back out for Mishon Johnson. Mishon going, drops it underneath. Kelly not quite ready for it. Saints with numbers coming back off the turnover. Left corner three. It is no good. Mishon Johnson has it here for Potsdam. Bears 44 and St. Lawrence 43. Again, the scoreboard showing the Bears with a two-point lead. I'm pretty certain it's just one. And a long three attempt from Hustis is a little bit too long as the ball hops up on the guy wire. It is back over to St. Lawrence. Here's Soroka checking back in for the Saints. St. Lawrence ball. Hicks open right corner, opts against the three. He'll go inside and score two off glass. And the lead goes back to St. Lawrence at 45-44.
Here's Tyrese on the reverse. Left it a little bit flat. Saints rebound, pushing tempo. Down the other way. Rolling off the screen. Long two, no good. Tyrese with the rebound for Potsdam. Saints by one, 45-44. Huestis, right wing corner, three, long. Scrapping for the rebound. Saints will get it, and they'll outlet to Soroka. Soroka, cross-court Hicks. Hicks cruising through the lane, puts it up, no good, but draws the foul on Tyrese Baptiste, and that's going to be his fourth. And that's going to be bring Brandon Seeger Jr. back on the floor here for Potsdam, and Potsdam's going to have to deal for now with one of their smaller lineups against the Saints. Two free throws coming for Luke Hicks. First one, good. As the Saints I'm seeing two totally different scores here between the live stats and the game clock here. I believe the Saints lead 46-44. Potsdam with a chance to tie. Inside, Seeger will take the easy two. On a little poker up there, tying the game at 46. Saints ball. Tight ball game. We are tied. I don't think either score right now is correct. Inside block shot by Kelly. Here come the Bears. Three on three. Drop it back for Michon. Michon kicks it out. Huestis for three. It's short. Rebound underneath for Trent Adamson. Saints in transition. Soroka sees a path to the basket. Lays it up and in. Scoreboard as Seeger misses inside. Much to the dismay of Coach Bechtel. 2 points the other way for St. Lawrence. I wish I could tell you what the actual score is. Honestly, I really don't know. Live stats are showing St. Lawrence 49-46. Ball tipped out of bounds. Bears will keep it underneath. The scoreboard showing 51-47. So, under 7 minutes to go in this one. St. Lawrence has led most of the way. Bears have led on a few occasions. A couple 1-point leads back in the first half. I believe a couple of leads here in the middle part of the second. Still working at it here with Kelly. On the possession for Potsdam. Nice pass through for Seeger. Spin move up. No good. Too strong. Rebound Adamson. Saints on the move. Bears hustle back on D. Soroka. Screen from Cowan. Step back from the free throw line. Good. 6.5 minutes to play. Saints, according to the scoreboard, by six right now at 53-47. Live stats showing St. Lawrence 51-46 in the lead. I don't know who to believe right now. But the Saints do have a lead. That much I can tell you. On the road in hockey, 3-0 disadvantages for both hockey teams, men at Fredonia, women at Cortland. Geneseo has had their way with Rutgers Camden. That game has gone final 96-71.
Score. Live stats is right. No. That's correct. That's the official score. Live stats can't find, doesn't know where the we, live stats must have missed a point. The book says the score on the scoreboard.
Okay.
The
so we're okay. Thank you. All right. So the official score is the scoreboard. I guess live stats had missed the point. I don't know why. All of a sudden it appeared. It went from 44 to 45, which is what led to my confusion and questioning of it. So live, the scoreboard is good. We are told officially at St. Lawrence 53, Potsdam 47. Potsdam ball. Side out, front of the Potsdam bench, Mison Johnson. For Houston. To Mison. Backdoor cut, misses. It'll be Seeger to take it, misses the lay-in. Looked like Williamson had it, stolen away from behind by a bigger player. Here's Soroka floating one up, no good. The tip won't go. Williamson rebounds here for Potsdam, and he's fouled by Soroka. So the Bears dodge a bit of a bullet right there as Soroka was left relatively unguarded on his way to the basket but blew a short lay-in attempt. And now the Bears are in the bonus, shooting one-on-one and one. Williamson to the line. Bears didn't get many free throw attempts in the first half at all, just a couple, made good on one of them. Here's Williamson front, and it is no good. Rebound secured by Aiden McCauley of St. Lawrence. So the Saints still up by six with 5:45 to play. McCauley, again a big high screen set by Cowan. Cowan gets the ball now. Looking to hand it off, though, so to McCauley. Gets the pick. Around it comes McCauley. Swings it left side. Ball up for grabs. Regathered with five to shoot. McCauley switching, turning in the paint. Puts it up. No good. Shot clock. Well, it should be a shot clock violation. That ball should have been still live. So how are they going to determine possession here? They're going to honor the shot clock going off? Yes, they are. I think. Initial indications are Potsdam ball. And they're going to go to St. Lawrence with it. Coach Bechtel not with any real argument over that. So he accepts the findings of the jury. Saints ball underneath. 20 on the shot clock. Inbounded and a reach around foul on Brandon Seeger Jr. This is one thing that has been pretty evident here tonight. Those little touch fouls, reach around fouls, or just reaching out in front of another player to try to poke the ball away or deny the pass, those are getting called every time. So at the line goes Andy Downs. He'll hit his first. Here's Andy's second try, also good. A couple of big points there, potentially, that opens up the lead to three possessions at 55-47. Potsdam with Seeger. Bottled up. Now a little space opens up. We'll hand it back to Kelly. Williamson, nice pass down for Brandon Seeger Jr., who looked like he was getting hacked at. He'll score the two, but no more. 55-49, Bears back down six. Saints ball, Cowan holds, left of the top of the key. Soroka explodes to the basket, scores on the reverse. St. Lawrence back to an 8-point lead. Tyrese Baptiste is going to come back in with four fouls in just a moment. Kelly, ball strip, gets it back. Nice pass, up, and a charge called here on the landing against Brandon Seeger Jr. Missed opportunities costing the Bears right now. with 4.5 minutes even to play in this game. 57-49, St. Lawrence on top by 8. And a chance to go up double digits once again. And that's 4 fouls now on Brandon Seeger Jr. He's got to stay out there. They need his scoring ability too much. St. Lawrence looking to go 4-0 to start the season. With a bunch of road games. Here's a floater, free throw line, in and out. The miss by Soroka, rebound Tyrese. And Tyrese throws it away. 4:05 on the clock. Saints ball backcourt, in for Soroka. Soroka calls the play, hands to Cowan. Cowan looking, dishes off Soroka, has the dribble, floats it down low. Adamson, out it goes. Cut toward the basket, down Soroka for three. Long, and a rebound for Kelly, and over the back comes Cowan. So back down the other end for free throws for the Bears. Going to the line will be Parker Kelly. I'm sure that Coach Bechtel was hoping to get a few more players into the lineup, which would signify that you're in control of a game, but that has not been the case here tonight. Saints have held a lead for the majority of this contest. Sam has led a couple of times, a few times, by a point or two. 1-1 for Kelly. Front end good this time. After he missed the last time out on a pair of free throws. Missing the first that time, but here he is good to earn himself a second try. As the Bears hit 50 points. Scoring 77 at Skidmore, but not quite enough to win over the Thoroughbreds Tuesday night as the Bears fell by 3. Kelly good on both free throws. Looked really clean on both. 57-51. Soroka drives, loses the ball. Taken by Tyrese, thrown away and gotten right back here by Kelly. Seeger Jr. on the move for the Bears. Brandon, one-on-one, pitches it away in the corner. Bears didn't run the play properly that time. Nobody home in that right wing corner. Honestly, I'm not even sure who was supposed to be. Bears need to get a stop. Down by 6, 3:10 to go. Dribble penetration outside Downs. Left-handed three is good. Andy Downs hits from downtown to make it a 9-point Saints advantage. 3 minutes to go. St. Lawrence 60, Potsdam 51. Tyrese Baptiste in the paint draws a foul, reaching against Downs. That'll stop the clock at 2:54 to go. Don't forget, Bears back in action Sunday afternoon, a rare Sunday matinee. 2 o'clock start time against Clarkson. We'll have it for you live here on Mix 96.1 in the SUNY Potsdam Bearcast. Tyrese missing what will be the final 1-1 opportunity for the Bears. Next Saints foul, the Bears will be in the double bonus. Saints are 2 Potsdam fouls away from being in the double bonus themselves. Here's Downs. Inside, has to pitch it outside. Hicks is open for 3, misses way long. Tyrese will gather it on the baseline. Bears pushing with 2.5 minutes to play. Tyrese to Meshon Johnson. Over for Kelly. Hot hand from 3, as is this guy, Colton Huses. Goes for Tyrese Baptiste. Spin move, up draws a foul. And Tyrese is going to go to the line, shooting 2. That's That's team foul number 10 on St. Lawrence here in the second half. Who's that foul on? I don't think I got the call. It hasn't been posted. Tyrese misses the first shot. Bears have not necessarily done themselves any favors at the free throw line tonight. Not that they had much opportunity in the first half, mind you, but here in the second half, not necessarily taking advantage. Missed second shot, but Seeger will get it. Ball stripped out of his hands and out of bounds. Last touch by Will Engelhardt, who had stripped it out of Seeger's hands. And Coach Bechtel, before the next Potsdam possession ensues, will get the timeout called with 2:13 to play. Bears down three possessions at 60-51. Potsdam at the free throw line in this game. Just 5 of 11. You hate to be leaving 6 points at the line with the shot clock or with the clock turned off. Saints, meanwhile, have hit two-thirds of their opportunities, 14 of 21. So a 9-point edge on free throws overall, a 9-point lead in the game. Not necessarily a fair one-for-one look there, but still an indication of where a lot of this deficit has come from. Potsdam ball underneath. Mishon Johnson to put it in play. Eustace goes in motion. Eustace will get it on a cut baseline. Hanger there is good. Mid-range jumper, nothing but net there for Colton Eustace. Bears within 7 as we approach 2 minutes to play. Here's your 2-minute warning. Potsdam down 7. Saints 60, Bears 53. Cowan, ball poked away, gets it back for Soroka. Soroka with Mishon guarding him now. Oh my. Didn't look like much, but again, in all fairness, they've been calling the touch fouls all night long. That's 2 fouls now on Mishon Johnson. Team foul number 9 for the Bears. As the Saints bring Adamson back in for Cowan. Soroka to the line, shooting 1-1, but might as well be 2. No, this is the front end. Okie dokes. Both teams double bonus now for the final minute 40. Bears are down by 7 points. With the ball, Seeger Jr. to the basket. Up shot blocked out of bounds by Adamson. Bears will keep 17 to shoot. The Bears don't want to be taking too much shot clock now. They got to be driving the basket. Johnson. Seeger is open. Can't see him. 5 seconds? Boy, that was a quick 5 seconds called right there. I gotta say. I've seen longer periods of time elapse than that without the 5 second call being issued. So it's back over to St. Lawrence. Bears come up empty. Mishon has Soroka. Almost lost the baseline, but he's a good ball handler, so he's able to keep it and move it back outside. Saints will certainly be content to work a little shot clock here now as Kelly goes diving for the ball and gets called on the foul. No foul issues there for Kelly, but it is going to be double bonus time for the Saints. And taking 2 will be Aiden McCauley, first-year player from Lowville. From the Lowville Academy and Central School. Kelly picking up his 3rd foul. And McCauley missing his first of 2 free throws. Bears still within striking distance here. Just have not been able to find
consistent scoring from really any source here tonight, aside from Tyrese Baptiste over the first, let's say, two-thirds of the game. Second free throw is made, and the lead is at 8 with a minute 16 to go. Inbounded for Meshawn Johnson. Meshawn, check it up against Andy Downs. A quickly motor, little cat and mouse game going on there. Here's Seager. Seager at free throw line. Kelly for 3. Off the back rim, no good. Baseline rebound, St. Lawrence. Off it goes to Soroka, and Kelly will give him a little hip presence. The foul gets called. Kelly's 4th. 2 free throws other way for Soroka. Bears in danger of falling to 0-2 to start the season. Meanwhile, the Potsdam hockey team's not faring any better as Soroka hits his first. The men still down 3-0 at Fredonia. Early third period, the women are trailing at Cortland 4-0 right now. Soroka good on the first, and the second is up, and it is no good. Rebound for Brandon Seager. Here comes Seager. Splits the D. Lays it up and scores. No foul call, but we'll take the 2. Timeout Potsdam with just under a minute to go. 54.9 on the ticker. Bears are back within 7 points. And I don't think we're going to get any other scores from Suniac basketball teams in action other than the one we already know about. That's Geneseo handling Rutgers Camden in Geneseo 96-71. And right now, I got to say, I'm just a little bit too lazy to go digging into other schools' websites for live stats. Because right now, the games really don't mean a whole heck of a lot. Still preseason action. Bears men and women will open Suniac play next weekend here at home on the Jerry Welsh Gymnasium floor. We'll have all 4 of their games this coming weekend, as in a week from tonight. We start with that. So Saints ball following a Potsdam timeout. Saints need to guard against a home run ball, as Williamson will come out on that. Bears looking for a backcourt turnover. Meshawn Johnson, and it's going the other way. Meshawn draws the pair control foul against Hicks. Meshawn Johnson, he knows how to play defense. Reginald Smith Jr. out on the floor for Potsdam 2. Probably, I would think, to take a foul for the team and stop the clock if that's what the need is at the time. But the Bears do win possession back, down by 7 with 49.5 seconds to play. St. Lawrence, as we mentioned tonight, coming in with a 3-0 record. Wins over both Alfred teams, Alfred State, Alfred U. And also a win over North Country rival Plattsburgh State. Let's see what Potsdam's schedule is looking like after the home game against Clarkson Sunday afternoon at 2. The Bears are on the road at Plattsburgh Tuesday night, which is when they will actually open Suniac play. So my bad on that call. Men and women will be over in Plattsburgh on Tuesday night. Of course, Potsdam and Plattsburgh being travel partners in conference. And then the Suniac home opening weekend is next weekend. Friday night against New Paltz, Saturday afternoon. So Friday night against New Paltz, Saturday afternoon against Oneonta. Women at 5:30, men at 7:30 on Friday. Women at 2, men at 4 on Saturday, December the 4th.
Let's get through this one first. Bears down by 7 points with the ball. Deep three, short. Rebound tapped up, and away with it will come Trent Adamson off the missed three from Houston. And Mishon will commit the foul to stop the clock and save some time with 41.4 on the clock now. Mishon Johnson, guilty of the foul, two free throws for number two, Trey Soroka. He's had himself a pretty good night. A real good find here for these Saints. And he's not the only one as he hits his first. Soroka now with 15 points. Make it 16. There is not number 17 as he misses that one. He's about 50% at the line. Pull up three. Brandon Sigurd Jr. good. Bears down 5, 68. Make that 63-58 with 32.7 on the clock. Quick foul by the Bears. And free throws at the other end. That's the time left on the second half clock. Two free throws here. Is this a technical foul? The PA system here had issues in the women's opener a week ago. Or actually earlier this past week. We have not really been getting any updates from the PA. And no, it's apparently not a technical foul because the Bears are going back out there. I think probably Mishon, or somebody has fouled out. I think that's the case. Now what? What is this all about? I'm trying to follow things as best I can, but I really don't know. So I guess we do have an intentional or technical foul of some sort. So with a 5-point lead at 63-58, the Saints have Hicks at the line shooting two. And are they going to get possession after that? Probably. Hicks' first try is good. Hicks now two out of, make that a 4 out of 10 at the line. Another shot coming. That one's up and that one's good. Hicks pointing to the scoreboard. Not that he necessarily needs to. I'm not quite sure what the point is. And now apparently some technical free throws. Two of them coming. And I guess this is looking to be one of those late game points of separation as he hits his third straight at the line. And one more coming. The Bears had just closed within five, but like that, they're back down nine. 67-58, half a minute to play. Brandon Singer, pull up three. No good, contact, he's down. Offensive rebound out for Houston. He hits the three with 22 seconds to go. Jim Bechtel cannot believe that there was not a foul called on the three ball attempt. As the Bears will get the clock stopped. As Viskovich showing some of that Messina hustle. Dived in and gets the foul to stop things up. Bears down six again following the Houston three. Hicks again at the line. Just hit four in a row. This one is off. Bears are hoping for him to miss another one to keep it a two-possession lead. But he hits it. Saints up seven, 20 seconds left. Bears pushing with Mishon Johnson. Mishon left corner, Williamson three, no good. Offensive rebound, not there. Andy Downs will get it. Falls right into his lap, and Andy's going to get free throws after getting fouled with 12 seconds to go. 12.1 on the clock. Meshawn Johnson is fouled out. Meshawn will finish with 4 points tonight. As Hicks comes out and McCauley is back in for St. Lawrence, who's going to replace Meshawn on the floor? I guess they'll decide. Oh, we have the replacement, Brian Pott. Didn't see him come out there. Andy Downs, the other number five, or the number five for St. Lawrence, hits his first free throw. And the southpaw, good on both. That should pretty much seal it. A 9-point St. Lawrence lead with just 12.1 seconds left. Timeout for St. Lawrence University. Well, the Potsdam men's hockey team has a goal, but they're down 4-1. Potsdam's first goal scored in three games. Can we figure out who scored this year? And it's Rob Clare. Well, that's good for Rob. The Bears back within 4-1 on the road at Fredonia. They'll be playing Buffalo State tomorrow. The Potsdam women have scored a goal as well, Kaylee Merrill, but they are trailing 5-1, and it looks like that game has gone final down in Cortland. Cortland looks to be the pretty much the cream of the crop. Here we are, final 10 seconds. Seeger hanging three, no good. Rebound is for McCauley. And St. Lawrence will walk this one out. I think we should, well, I guess they're going to let it go. It should be a turnover on a travel to Potsdam, but they're going to let it go. And the Potsdam Bears battled throughout this game, but really never found a scoring rhythm and fall by 9 points. That's first half there. It's just first half. So the final score here is St. Lawrence 70 and Potsdam 61. As the Bears drop to 0-2 on the young season, not a whole lot of time to recover. They'll have tomorrow off before hosting Clarkson University Sunday afternoon at 2 o'clock. And we hope you'll be able to join us for that one then. As the Bears fall to St. Lawrence 70-61. Meshawn Johnson with some nice sportsmanship shown there, reconnecting, it would appear, with, what was that? Oh, Tommy Flanagan from Norwich, New York, first-year player himself. So anyway, Meshawn fouls out with 4 points, and the Bears fall to 0-2, while St. Lawrence rises to 4-0, as they must be heading into Liberty League play really quickly, I would think. For Potsdam, Suniak play opens at travel partner Plattsburgh this coming Tuesday evening, but of course before that we have
1 point. Just haven't corrected the 1 point.
Okay, so thanks. Yeah, I just saw that. I saw it go from 44-45 with the clock stop, so I was wondering. All right. So let's check out the overall numbers here. First, the team numbers in Potsdam's 70-61 loss to the St. Lawrence Saints. For the St. Lawrence University Saints, 20-51 overall from the floor. They certainly cooled off in field goals in the second half, but the Bears really didn't step it up. And St. Lawrence still outshoots the Bears from the floor 39.2% to 37.9%. St. Lawrence 20-51 overall. The Bears 25-66. So the Bears got the shots off. They got some good looks. And tonight was just not a night when the Bears were going to find the bottom of the net, as it were. On three-point attempts, St. Lawrence finishes with six, but they got those 6 3-pointers on 18 tries, so they hit a third of their attempts. Meanwhile, the Bears were just under 20% in their three-point attempts, 5 of 26. Free throws. Hello, Miss Louise. And you as well. Thank you very much. Louise Elliott strolling by the broadcast location here at half court. Longtime North Country sports fan. And widow of the legendary Con Elliott. Turnovers in it. Well, let's get free throws. Let me do one thing at a time here. St. Lawrence, 24-36 at the line. They got a lot of opportunities. They hit two-thirds of them, 24-36. Meanwhile, the Bears, 6 of 11 at 54.5%. Turnovers were even at 16 apiece. Points off of turnovers, Potsdam 18 and St. Lawrence with 10. Total rebounds, a slight edge for St. Lawrence at 41-39. Offensive rebounds, that edge to the Bears at 12-9. D boards, 5 better for the Saints, 32-27 in that department. Blocks, 3 for the Bears, a couple for the Saints. Not a big part of the game. Steals, pretty much even, 7-6 Potsdam. Fouls, not even. Potsdam whistled for 27 fouls to the Saints, 15. Bench points, St. Lawrence came on strong in the second half to take that battle. Second chance points, clearly in favor of the Bears. Points in the paint, that's where Potsdam got most of their scoring from, 36-22. Fast break points, 5-point edge to St. Lawrence University. Let's take a look now as we wind things down here at the individual statistics. For the visiting St. Lawrence Saints, who improved to 4-0, they had 4 players in double figures. Co-leaders Will Engelhart and Trey Soroka led the way for their team with 16. 14 points on the night for Luke Hicks. A lot of them coming from the free throw line down the stretch in the second half. And the Saints get a double-double, 11 and 11 from Trent Adamson. Also, 4 points from Aiden McCauley, 7 from Andy Downs, as he went a perfect 4-4 at the line. And singletons, well, 2 points. Let me get the right category here. I'll check the right column. That would help, right? 2 points for Miles Davis. And I mentioned the 4 for McCauley. Okay, there we go with the Saints numbers. For the Potsdam Bears, a game-high 18 from Colton Hustis, one of 3 Potsdam players to reach double figures, followed by Tyrese Baptiste with a double-double of 12 and 12, 11 points from Parker Kelly. And on down we go to 9 points from Brandon Seeger Jr., 4 from Mishon Johnson before he fouled out very late in the game, the final half minute. And 2 apiece for Jeff Williamson, Chris Becker, and Dante Viskovich. Couple points, or a point apiece for Brian Pod and Austin Dropkin. Dropkin in particular, I thought, played very well coming off the bench here tonight for the Potsdam Bears. Potsdam falls to 0-2 prior to hosting the Clarkson University Golden Knights. Men's basketball action coming up on Sunday afternoon. We'll have it for you with tips scheduled for 2 o'clock. Quick check on the out-of-town scoreboard. In hockey, 5-1 is your score. Both games. Fredonia leading Potsdam. Cortland leading Potsdam on the women's side. So looks like both Potsdam hockey teams headed for another notch on the L side of the column. But they'll be back in action. Certainly the men will be going back into things tomorrow night against Buffalo State. Let's see what the Potsdam women are doing, just so we can be not only complete but also fair. The Potsdam women's hockey team will be playing their next game after tonight at Oswego, and that is tomorrow afternoon at 3 o'clock. Another
any WHL league contest for the Potsdam Lady Bears. And yes, their game at Cortland has gone final at 5-1 for the home team. So they're back in action at 3 o'clock against Oswego. The guys will finish up their road weekend at Buffalo State tomorrow night. And we'll be back here with you. Hope you'll be joining us Sunday afternoon, Potsdam men's basketball against the Clarkson Golden Knights. Tip-off scheduled for 2 o'clock. Bears dropped this one by the final of 60-51. Make that 70-61. I'll get that right. Same margin, a 9-point loss. Bears slipped to 0-2 to start off the season. They'll see what they can do against the Clarkson Golden Knights on Sunday afternoon. And we invite you to join us for that broadcast at that time. 2 o'clock is the opening tip, scheduled time. Thanks to Dan Bronson and the entire sports information crew here at SUNY Potsdam. And to Lucas back at Mission Control at the Mix 96.1 studios for engineering tonight's broadcast. I'm Warren Potter. Thank you so much for joining us. Have a great weekend. We'll see you back here Sunday afternoon on the SUNY Potsdam Bearcast and Mix 96.1. Thank you. Good night.